everyone, it's Tammy, and it is time to do my plan with me. This is in my Reset Girl planner, and I love this planner. It is not only a beautiful planner, but I also love that it is motivational planner. I think it's fun. It makes me happy. So I like to do it. I usually just do the first two lines, and then the last line I use for some of the things that I know I need to do. So I'm just kind of giving you an example. I don't know why I do this with this one. I don't usually do that with the other ones, but whatever. So I've picked out a few things that I know I want to use. I'm feeling kind of, I don't know the word, friendly this week. So I'm going to pull out these two pages before I actually get started. And I need, my friends just mean a lot to me this week. And this includes all of you. I know that, I don't know. Some of you have recently said things like, Tammy, you always make me happy. You make me smile. And you're so funny. And I mean, just sweet comments. I always get such the nicest comments. And I have to tell you that I feel the same way. If you guys don't know that, I need to tell you, because I never, ever, ever thought in a million years that I would have the subscribers that I do. And you guys are so kind and so thoughtful and so nice. And I mean, it's just amazing to me. You guys have given me gifts, and I mean, just, I never ever thought. And you guys make me happy. When I read my comments, it takes me to a whole different place. I feel so happy. And I really appreciate it. And this week I have been kind of down. You know, things just have gotten to me. And I'm not going to say down. I've just felt not excited about some things. And, you know, you kind of wonder if you've made right decisions, and all of those kinds of things have just kind of hit me this week. And you guys have just lifted me up, and I appreciate it very much. And every time I read you guys' comments, there's a big smile on my face. I really wish you guys could see me. I mean, because I literally am smiling from ear to ear. And sometimes you guys bring me to tears. It's crazy. I mean, I'm not like bawling my head out, but like tears come to my eyes. It's crazy. And I'm not that person. So I got this from Beth. And it says, friends are the family you choose. And I am putting this on here because as soon as I saw it, well, I was looking for, this is how I kind of do my planners when I'm not really sure what I want to do with it. And this planner I treat differently than like my main planner or whatever. This one I have the liberty to make bulky if I want to or whatever. So I don't feel restricted to just stickers in this planner. So at first I thought, ooh, I might do some stamping in this planner. I have my new Gorgeous Girl stickers. Maybe I'll do that. So then I thought, ooh, I'm going to use some new washi. And I really liked this washi. And I thought, oh, okay, this is good. So it's kind of pink and mint. So I thought, all right, what can I do? So I look over at my stash of stuff that I keep in the corner over here. It's just like, I don't know. Well, here, I can show you. Cards that I've made that are kind of extra that I haven't sent out. I just got these from Beth, actually. These came from Beth. I have some scrap paper that I haven't used. I have another card that I either thought I would send out or it just didn't get sent. I don't know yet. Some extra flowers that I had. Some embellishments. I just keep stuff over here. And actually, here's the whole slew of these cards. So I must have just grabbed it from that. So I haven't even put these cards away yet, because I made all of these, so I need to put these away, actually. And then I have just all sorts of things. So it's like, it's just a hodgepodge of stuff. And so I start looking through that, and I came across these. And this one was in the first row, and it was on the bottom. And I'm like, oh man, that is good. And it hit me that I needed to use it. So I was like, oh, all right, yeah, I'll use that. So then I picked out this. And then my next step was, well, I thought that I kind of wanted to stamp. So I thought, well, I'll get a gorgeous girl. And I didn't want to just put the gorgeous girl on the paper. And then I found this mint. And I thought, ooh, I'll stamp the gorgeous girl on the mint. And I thought, no, because then I couldn't color it. So I need to do that in white. But then the mint happened to match this exactly. So I thought, oh, great, I'll do that. And then I thought, well, I'll do white so I could still scrap or still stamp the mint. And then I thought, well, I don't want just a big piece of white paper over here. This one doesn't even look like it might not be big enough to do it the way I want to. So maybe I'll use this one. And then, so I thought, well, I'll file these doilies and I put these down. So, I mean, that's the way that my head works with this kind of thing, just so you guys know. So, I mean, that's where I came from when I was looking at what to do on this one. Yeah, I think I will do the bigger one so that I can make sure that I cover up what I want to cover up. So, yeah, you guys really are the family that I choose. Not that I wouldn't choose my regular family, too. Well, most of them. Just that my family has passed away. Like, I mean, you guys know that. Well, most of you know. Some of, I don't talk about it a lot because it's been a long time. But my parents have both passed away. So I miss them every day. But I don't talk about them every day. It's gotten... Time does make things a little easier in that way. And then whenever I do think about it, it does bring tears to my eyes. I mean, I still, honest to goodness, cry. I mean, I could sob with that kind of a thing when I start thinking about, you know, that. So I don't let myself go there a lot. 'Cause it's hard. You guys know if you've experienced loss like that. I can't imagine the loss of a child, but the loss of your parents is huge. Especially since I'm still a baby myself. I'm only 29. I was born in 1971. Actually, I joke about that, but I did lose both of my parents by the time I was 29. I was 26 when my dad passed away, and I was 29 when my mom passed. So that is an awful age to lose your parents. I mean, any age is an awful age, but 29, that's way too young. Ooh, I kind of like it like that. And then I'll put my gorgeous girl right here. What do you guys think? Or do I put a gorgeous girl here? But see, if I did that, then I wouldn't be able to color her. Okay, I'll put her here. So that is my thought process. Kind of crazy sometimes, but... Need my basic black. Clean her up, clean her up, clean her up, clean her up. I'm going to use colored pencils that I have right over here to color this sweet girl. Ugh. There we go. And I need a drink of my juice. WMO. It is 1:30 in the morning, and I have been to bed, and I'm back up, and I'm drinking apple juice right now because I'm afraid if I drink coffee that I'll be up. Although it really doesn't do that to me, but I don't know. I figure I don't want to take that chance. So let me go ahead and color her, and then I'll do that stuff. So let's see. I'm going to take out a piece of paper just to use as a scrap. Oh, I have one over here. In case I want to see what color something is or whatnot. And I think that this is black, yes. Sometimes it's hard to tell on colored pencils. And I think one of the reasons I like the Gorgeous Girl so much is that they usually show you them all colored in black. Let's see. Is she not colored in black, but like their hair is dark. See? I love that. And I think that some of that is because, I mean, my hair is dark and my whole family's hair was dark. And growing up, most of the Barbie and the princesses and all of them have blonde hair. I remember wishing I had blonde hair so badly. And my hair was actually the lightest hair in the family for a while. That's how dark my family has hair. I mean, like, we, most people call our hair black. I call it dark brown, but honestly, I can see why people call it black. Because now that I have Taz, our new pup, people call him black. I would call him black. But then when you really get to know him and you know who he is and you watch him and you can see him, he totally is brown. He's just dark brown. Not just. He is dark brown. But in some light, he totally looks black. But when I first got him, I was like, no, he's a black dog. He is totally a black dog. But now when I look at him, I'm like, no, he's a brown dog. He's so dark that it looks black. And I think that that's what is up with my hair and my family's hair. I mean, we know that it's brown, but to the average person, it totally looks black. And I remember when my kids were young, neither one of my kids have dark hair. My husband has, well, his hair is brown now, but when we were married, it was black. Or, sorry, no, it wasn't. It was blonde. And, both of my kids have darker hair than him, but it's totally light compared to mine. And I thought for sure one of my kids would have dark hair. It's so funny, but they didn't. So let's see. I think I'm going to use mint if I have it and pink to go with theme. And I was going somewhere with that, too. I don't remember exactly what else I was going to say about it. Yeah, those colors are good. Oh, this is what I was going to say about it. So my kids, you know, have light hair. And so I noticed that about other people's kids. And it was so funny to me because it's like all of the kids in their class, all the white Caucasian kids in their classes have almost the same colored hair. I mean, it's like all a light brown color. It's so funny. When you see one with really dark hair or really blonde hair, it was like they stood out because they looked different than the others. It was wild. I kind of thought that was funny. And then, of course, the Hispanic kids had, you know, the really dark hair. And we have, it's pretty diverse around here. So, I mean, there were lots of different colors of hair, but it was crazy. Like the Caucasian kids all were sporting about the same color. It was so funny. And I don't know if that's just a regional thing. I'm not really sure. I don't remember feeling like I had super dark hair as a kid. So now I'm just rambling and thinking out loud. Because I don't remember feeling like my hair was any different from anybody else's. And I'm trying to remember what my friends' hair colors were. I remember I had a friend named Leanne, and she had dark hair. But then I had some friends that totally had light hair, too. I don't know, it's funny. Maybe times have changed it, you know? We're more of just the melting pot has ended in everybody having like light brown hair. I don't know. So anyway, that was my whole story. Like, I loved Snow White because she had dark hair. I mean, I do remember feeling that way. Like, oh, I want them to look like me. Kind of funny. Oops. These colored pencils I got at Target. No, I didn't. I got them at Michael's. Because Tanya told me that they were really good. She was like, these are really nice markers for $5. Because the whole thing is $5 and there's 36 of them. So I thought, oh, okay, let me try them. I don't know what color vermilion is. Is it an orange? I don't know. This says cherry red. I'm using that one. I didn't realize they had their names on them. Let's see here. I need like... So there's, 36 pieces for $5. And these are really good markers. Push down really hard to get some color going into this one. Kind of like how I did her dress, like ombre-ish. I'm gonna get another drink. Yummo, yummo, yummo. I guess I'll do her socks, like pink and green. Not this pink, but this one. These little girls are so cute. They're fun to color too because you can do anything. There we go. I'm gonna call that good. Let me put these back. A couple of them are caught on the back, I think. There we go. Oops. I don't know what this is. Oh, I don't think I need to keep that. Tips and tricks on using your colored pencils. Alright, let's get this paper off. So this is probably a longer plan with me and this planner than I usually do, but I just took you right along with the coloring process and try to tell you the thinking process. Then I rambled on and on about hair color. I just thought of something. Let's see if this works out. I'm gonna grab something over here. Some spray. Tutti Frutti sounds pretty. Tutti Frutti. Oh, Rudy. Okay, wish me luck. Oh, I don't want to cover up. Not all that hair. The sprayer doesn't spray very straight. I have it all over me. And that is okay. I'm just letting it kind of dry a little bit. I'm going to pick up this get a baby wipe. Clean up my pink arm. Yay. It went over on this side, but that's okay. I'm not even gonna worry about it. It's kind of cute. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is take my heat gun and dry this. Really pretty. Okay, note to self when I'm using these, I should probably see how it sprays prior to, because that sprayer just went crazy. I'm gonna put that over there. Gosh, this is pretty. I wonder what I'm gonna use that for. Well, now I'm not sure that I want to put this down here. I think I'm gonna save that and use it for something else. And the other side is still white, so if I wanted to use it as a white one, I still could. But I like this pink, that it's all sparkly. So totally changed my mind, but I kind of like it down there. Okay, so now I'm going to take my fine-tipped glue. I'm going around the edges. And then I'm going to go in the middle. I don't know, I'm just kind of making this the way up. That should be okay. That's pretty cute. Excuse me. And this washi was an inspiration behind it all. And I think I got this from AliExpress, if any of you guys are interested. They have some really cute washi. And it's like a dollar a roll. Wish that I didn't do that. Or I hope it dries better. But I have the feeling it won't, but a girl can dream. Oh no. Oh goodness. This usually doesn't happen. Maybe I need to be more careful with my washing, pulling out skills. I need to put the dates up here. So the 23rd, so this would be the 24th, 25th, 'Kay, so then I like to write things down that I know that I need to do for Stampin' Up! Or YouTube. Mostly Stampin' Up!, but, you know, a little of both. One thing that I know I need to do is I need to video card series. I need to, this is a Stampin' Up! Meeting night. I don't know why I put meeting night, because I said it. Sometimes I crack myself up. Stampin' Up! Meeting night, and I wrote it. What a dingbat. Oh well. I know that I need to leave comments. I'm going to write that. I've been better about not leaving them for like 5 days and then coming back and dreading it. I've been better. Let's see. The 30th. Ooh, this is the last day for the card club. Picked out the June card club yet. I need to do that out of the new catalog. And then I'm going to put here pre-order Stampin' Up! Starting May 1st. then I also need to leave Etsy feedback. Oops. That looks funny, but oh well, I know what it says. And then I also need to check AliExpress and make sure that I've gotten everything. All right, I think that's it. This is the very last week. And this is this week. And here is next week. That is really cute. And then we go into May. Wow. Well, thanks guys for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this planner and the little chit chat goofball. And thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful week. Bye bye.